I'm Gabriel Mwako, and I welcome you all to Ghana Tennis TV. I have here with me a man who is an inspiration to physical challenge people in the country. Though he's a physical challenge man, but that doesn't stop him. He's out there to help his colleagues, and he's doing love and laughter with Yes I Can games. And this is the third edition happening right here at the Accra Sports Stadium. Mr. Felix, welcome to Ghana Tennis TV.
Thank you.
Tell us something about Felix Agbostu. When someone asks, who is this?
Well, the name is Agbostu.
Agbostu?
Yeah, so like you said, my name is Felix Agbostu. I'm an ex-service personnel. I served in the British Army. I served in the Iraq War, after which I had a road traffic accident shortly after I got back. So I ran a healthcare agency as well as the foundation, the Simon Agbostu Foundation for the Young Disabled. So in a nutshell, that's what I do.
You came down to run a foundation, named the foundation after your dad. Tell us more about it. Why not your name on it?
Okay, so when I had my accident, my family was of a great support to me.
Okay.
And my dad played a key role in my rehab and all that. Basically, he's an inspiration to me. So when he passed, I thought, why not start a foundation in his honor? So hence the name Simon Agbostu Foundation for the Young Disabled.
Okay, this is the third edition. This is the third edition.
Is it third or fourth?
Oh, this is the fourth edition. And tell us the number of disciplines that will take place at the stadium.
Okay, so we've got wheelchair tennis, we've got wheelchair basketball, we've got wheelchair racing, we've got skate racing, we've got goal ball for the blind, and then we've got table tennis. So,
a lot of foundations come, they do donation and go. But why are you into not just giving it to them, but rather introducing most people, physically challenged people, into the sports?
Before we go on, let me say it's not just Simon Agbostu Foundation doing this. We're doing this with the Go Get Them Wheelchair Racing Club.
Okay.
The whole idea why we have come together to do this is to empower the physically challenged through sports to get off the streets and do stuff for themselves.
Okay.
Yeah. So, I mean, you can do a donation today. Mm-hmm. You can give somebody money on the street, but then tomorrow they'll be back begging. But then if they could make a career out of sports, why not? That is why we do this.
Oh, okay. You've introduced a lot of sports. I mean, the fourth edition, what will be different among the previous editions?
We're doing the same disciplines we did before.
Oh, okay.
In the past, we've sourced new talent to nurture them and then take them higher if they can. We've been successful with just a couple. This time we're going to try to push and get more guys to start up doing something.
Okay.
Yeah.
So let me ask you this. I mean, what motivates, where is the motivation coming from to do this for physical challenge people?
Thing is, I had my accident in the UK.
Yeah.
And the kind of rehab and support that I got from the state, I got back home and I see people on the streets begging. And that, which is not a pretty sight, because I don't think it's safe on the streets for them. So at the end of the day, I ask myself, what can I do to get guys off the streets? That's motivation enough for me. I mean, giving my fellow physically challenged support to be able to do things for themselves.
So this year, when is the program starting?
9th of April.
Yeah. And how many participants are you expecting in Accra?
In Accra, when you say participant, you mean everybody involved?
Yes.
We're looking at about 1,500 people, reason being COVID, so we having to cut down. So yeah, it's a trip for 1,500.
Okay, the third edition, I witnessed the third edition where everybody was fed.
Yeah.
Everybody was giving transport back home.
Yeah.
Is it going to happen the same, or there's going to be an additional thing given to the participants coming?
It's just transport, food, and then because we want all COVID protocols observed, we're going to have a package which has got sanitizer mats and everything to make sure everybody is kept safe.
Wow, that's going to be so nice. I've seen the third edition, I saw a couple of people coming in, giving testimonies about you. I mean, how do you feel when people give testimonies that through your foundation they are able to do this and that?
At the end of the day, it's not about me. It's really not about me. I would say this. It gives me a lot of joy that at least one person has had an impact, or one person's life has been changed because of what we do. That's a joy to me. So it's really not about fame or about me. It's about how to change people's lives positively.
Okay, so those watching, what message do you have for your fellow which physical challenge people out there, so that it will motivate them to be on the court from 9th of April
April? It's just a one day event, so 9th of April.
What message do you have for anybody watching you that will motivate that person to be at the stadium on the 9th of April?
Okay, so I like the fact that you don't say disabled, and then you say physically challenged.
Thank you very much.
In my opinion, when you say physically challenged, it goes to say there's a limitation and not totally limited.
Yeah.
You understand?
Yeah.
So I can't use my legs, I can't use my hands, but then by the grace of God, I still got my brain, so I use my head. So the fact that you are physically challenged does not mean you shouldn't do anything for yourself or be on the street. You've got other abilities apart from your incapabilities. So then use your abilities to do something for yourself. It's not safe on the streets.
Very true.
Not safe on the streets. Not to talk of the sun that you stand in. So then, I would say, get out there, motivate yourself, do something for yourself. Come to the Accra Sports Stadium on the night, 9 a.m. Come and see the talents that fellow physically challenged are displaying. It's a humbling experience as well as a motivational one. And I'm sure by the end of the day, you'll be inspired and you'll find a discipline where you would want to fit in.
If I could remember very well, the third edition, apart from those doing sports, there are other avenues that you have also opened for those who are not interested in sports to also get in.
Yeah, we try to get people to learn a trade. Yeah. We avoid going towards setting up businesses for people because their funds might be misused and all that. So then we try to get guys to go and learn a trade.
Okay.
Guys who need their prosthetic limbs fixing, we pay for them to get fixed. We've got a couple of students in university whom we are supporting.
Wow. So your final words or your final submissions, so we call it a day.
Okay, so actually, I've got two things to say. I'm going to say it takes a lot to go into these events. when I say a lot, time, money, products. You talked about food. Now, at the end of the day, we're not asking you to put your hands in your pockets. If you're a business or you're an individual and you can provide products, even to use as prizes for the participants, or even to cook the food that we're going to serve these guys, by all means, we would welcome them. If you want to donate towards the cause as well, by all means, call us on 0244-446727. 0244-446727. And I would like to add that the day is not just for physically challenged. The general public are invited to come and experience talent that the physically challenged are displaying. It's like I said before, it's a humbling experience, and also it goes to give you a different mindset about stigmatization towards persons living with disability in the country.
A question just came up. Ghana Wheelchair Tennis were supposed to go to Portugal for a tournament, and they didn't get visa. They didn't get chance, or they didn't get access to go. When you hear such news, how do you feel as a person?
It saddens me. It's something that I'd wanted to talk about, but you didn't bring up. You see, at the end of the day, like I said, we were able to support just a couple of guys who we spotted during the third edition. Okay. Now, we can take them so far. You see, we can nurture them, train them, and take them so far.
Yeah.
But the nation or the state or the people in charge need to take them from where we get them to and give them the support and the exposure they need.
Moving forward, should they still rely on the federation, or do they take things within themselves so that they can move on?
I mean, you see, the thing is, you can't go past the federation.
Yeah.
You understand? But as an individual, I mean, before the interview, we were having a conversation where the issue about guys who are into sports still want to be on the street. My advice is, why not set up a small business of your own? Learn a trade of your own to support yourself. You see, so when the sport is not there, you don't play tournaments every day.
Yeah.
You understand? Also, the way we carry ourselves, the way we present ourselves, also matters. If you approach a corporate body and say, I would like you to sponsor me for my career, the way you present yourself, the way you carry yourself, also matters.
Yeah.
So let's try to do stuff for ourselves, as well as try to get in touch with corporate bodies, see how they can help. We understand times are hard, and sponsorship is difficult, but then very little you can do goes a long way.
Can you tell us some of the sponsors on board for this year's edition?
Well, at the moment, as it stands, not a lot. It's just myself and the family businesses. So,
ooh, okay.
Tina Travel and Tour, Willow Farms, okay. And Genesis Healthcare.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Very grateful for your time, and you're welcome. I'm very happy you came all the way from Teshi to
actually La Paz.
La Paz, wow. From La Paz to here to speak to us. Very grateful.
All right. Thank you very much for your time.
All right. Okay. So that's it for today. I am Gabriel Mwako. Keep on subscribing to Ghana Tennis TV.